especially because in this meeting is for our special group, one of the most important. We are involved, you know, in this, sector of research. That's all. to predict the evolution of the galaxy activity, the evolution of the cloud formation.
investigar these cases or this is the only need to analyze hydrogen or methane. And here we can see the operating condition in the different step that we start. The calcination will be always at 800 degrees. Solid crystallized with the presence of nickel oxide and nickel. The regeneration with hydrogen is even worse than the regeneration with oxygen. We obtain higher values for the crystal size. And an interesting thing is observe how the size of the nitrogen crystals in nickel magnesium alumina is lower than the size obtained for the nickel alumina, indicating a high degree of dispersion and interaction of the nickel with the sulfur in this case as the TPR resource in ocean. Unfortunately, we don't have so enjoy pictures from the documents, but we certainly appear some results. This is a micrograph. You can see all the filaments of carbon are hollow filaments, and at the tip of the filament we can see here the crystalline nickel. And these are the most important things in this picture. The same result is obtained at the 100 degrees and the rest of the condition is well.
However, the increase of methane does not appear to
as a medium condition nomina, and the behavior for all the galleries are more or less the same. We observe an increase of the iron content in the partial pressure of the method, but the activity of the galleries are different. By the medium emission lumina, the most active galleries, despite the only the half nickel content, for example, that the commercial galleries. In addition, we can see here how the difference in activity are more efficient and more strong, a higher partial pressure of methane, indicating that the kinetic order with respect to this variable is different from each current. Well, we observe the same result. Locking rate activity, therefore the current activity, and the sequence of activities medium and medium alumina, higher than medium alumina, and both much higher than medium alumina. Here we can see the effect of hydrogen concentration in the current activity. This is when we present the same erosion for the same calories. And in general, we can observe a diminution of locking rate as the hydrogen increases in the field. Also, we observe the same diminution in the hydrogen production, but at the very low, in this case, is pure octane without hydrogen in the field, a very low content of methane is pure correspond to the 2.5% value of hydrogen in the pure, the fissure. Very low hydrogen content, we don't observe this increase in behavior in the galleric activity, indicating that in this area we obtain a maximum in the activity as a function of the hydrogen content. Same result can be observed in the pure carbon concentration. This is the pure for the case of no hydrogen in the feed. And if we put a little bit of hydrogen in the feed, we observe an increase in the activity and, of course, in the concentration of carbon over carbons. But after that, we observe a diminution in the galleries, in the activities. Then, an increase of the partial pressure of hydrogen causes a diminution in the initial rate of locking, a sharp increase in the initial period of induction, an increase in the residual rate of locking, and also a sharp diminution of the deactivation rate. So the calories activity shows a maximum as a function of the hydrogen concentration, and this effect is due to the position because the hydrogen prevents the calories deactivation in the formation of the activating globe. Same behavior is obtained with all the calories, and the second of activity is more or less the same, but in this case, commercial calories, we don't observe the activation behavior, and in fact, we are here in the increasing period, we don't reach for this condition the maximum locking rate, and because of this, we only observe the increasing period for this condition. As regards the influence of the production temperature, we can see here of an increase in the production temperature of the galleries before the reaction. We observe an increase of the deactivation rate, a lowering in the maximum locking rate, and also a diminution in the activity as a function of the temperature reduction. For that cannabis, we observe only the part of the diminution, but in this case we also observe the part of the cure that an increase of the temperature reduction produces an increase of activity. This is a consequence of a higher degree of reduction attained. Reduction temperature is lower than 750 degrees, and after that we obtain a synthetic behavior. The cannabis is synthesized, we reduce our temperature, and of course we obtain the diminution of the activity as a consequence of this synthesis. So to sum up the effects of reaction temperature, we can see here how an increase of the this variable causes a diminution in the initial product production, an increase of the initial activity, and the carbon contained increases to a maximum and then decrease. At lower temperature at the maximum, we observe more activation than synthetic, and after that we observe more synthetic than activation, and the position of this maximum, the temperature of the maximum activity, the reduction temperature, is consequence of the degree of interaction of the nickel with the sulfur, and as shown before, for the nickel magnesium alumina, we have the higher degree of interaction between nickel and the sulfur. However, the reduction of the activity is not slightly modified by the reduction temperature. And the last viable study was the reaction temperature is, of course, a complex effect because there is a lot of step in the other surface, and each step has its own activation energy. Then the result of the variation in the reaction temperature is not so easy to interpret. In general, we can see that an increase in the temperature of reaction, we observe a sharp increase in the activation rate of the catalyst, an increase in the initial activity of the catalyst, and then we observe here how the maximum cooking rate is increasing in the temperature operation, but its maximum appear a lower time at high temperature. The same behavior is obtained with the hydrogen, and as a consequence of this connected steps, the evolution of the carbon concentration not follow a simple path. Here that the increase of the reaction temperatures causes a diminution of the initial current of induction, an increase of the initial activity of the catalyst, and also an increase of the rate of carbon flow, therefore increase of the catalyst activity, but also an increase in the activation rate. And this variable has not appeared to affect the residual activity of the catalyst. Well, after the reaction, we can do the regeneration of the catalyst by burning the carbon of the catalyst in a TPO experiment. This is the reduction reaction step, and after that, if we burn the carbon, we observe a lowering of the weight of the catalyst. And then also we can repeat the production and reaction step, and then a new regeneration state, and also a new process of reaction. And we can repeat this cycle many times. favor, these are the results of the time after, settled after the national cycle for all the Catholic system. In other cases, we observe how the first catalyst is the most active, and after the first regeneration, the activity of the catalyst suddenly increases. In other cases, news for us, the lab catalyst was the less resistant catalyst, apparently the less resistant catalyst, because after the first generation we lose a lot of the activity of the catalyst. And in the case of the commercial catalyst, we observe a lower diminution in the activity. But we must remember that in this case we have 70% of nitrogen in the catalyst. As we can consider that is example of this catalyst is begin the reaction, the cycle already synthesized, and in the regeneration cycle doesn't suffer much more synthesis, and because of this we use a slow diminution of the activity for this case. In order to explain this threshold after the regeneration cycle, we recover the evolution of the way during the reduction step after each cycle. These are the PPR experiment doing in the thermovalves. And we can see here for the formation of amino cannabis in this example, hope for the first cycle, the temperature of production is so high, it's more or less 70 degrees, but after the first cycle, the reduction peak is appears at lower temperatures, and the reduction start begins at the much more lower temperatures, nearly 300 degrees centigrade. In this case, we obtain a wider peak, and after that second reduction cycle, in the third cycle we obtain lower temperature reduction. The reduction starts at the same temperature, and in this case the peak is less snap. Therefore we observe here a deep change in the nickel-sulfur interaction after the regeneration stage, even if the regeneration is doing a lower temperature, we observe the same at the end of the cycle, the same behavior. Well, the effect of the regeneration cycle can be summarized as saying that the regeneration by cold combustion allows recovery initial activity, but not the initial activity. The main function of the activity loss is produced after the first regeneration step, and the loss of activity and decrease of the activation rate after the regeneration step are caused by the synthesis of the nickel crystals. Well, mechanism involving this reaction, especially after the presentation yesterday morning, but that enjoyed the presentation of Dr. Rostro Vincent, I don't need to say so much about this because it's brief. The methane decomposition suffered first absorption of methane and hydrogen over the nickel surface, and after the absorption, the composition, the breaking of the bonds between carbon and hydrogen are produced, and then the hydrogen is produced. And finally, we obtain carbon of the nickel surface. This carbon accumulates in a surface at the top, nickel crystallized, and due to the difference in the concentration between this part and the nickel super part, transfer of carbon, fusion of carbon throughout the crystalline based on the carbon diffusion from the nuclear crystallites. In addition of the carbon growing as a filament, we also observe, the deactivation of the calamase by the formation of oligomeric species over the surface of the nacre, and all of these things can be written as chemical reaction. Takes into account the nucleation product. the influence of methane concentration, and we observe excellent feed. Remember the multivariate way of feeding, and this allows, for example, calculate the order of the genetic order with respect, in this case, of the methane for all the cattle. We observe here of these values are higher than the obtained with the regular amino catalyst, explaining the obtained result before. In this case, we present the feeding obtained with the effect of the temperature of the reaction for the medium of the alumina, and this allows us the calculation of the activation energy involved in each step. And we fix, in this case, zero, a zero, the activation energy for the residual activity, and we obtain that for the nickel alumina catalyst, the activation energy involved in the carbon broad stage is lower than, higher than the activation energy involved in the activation stage, but in the other catalyst, remember the most active catalyst, the result is the closer. Finally, our the composition of methane is a potential alternative produced hydrogen and permeable material from natural gas, and for our catalyst we contain that all the catalysts that are active in this reaction, the addition of magnesium oxide has a beneficial effect on the activity of nickel alumina catalyst. This catalyst has a similar behavior to the commercial catalyst, in spite of being have